So just to recap, we did a heel and toe and added some stylish arms. We did a sweep, either frontwards or backwards. And then we did a fall off the log variation with a sweep going back into our fall off the log. Let's start with number one, heel and toe. We'll do it a few times. Then we'll do the sweeps, and then we'll do the, you know, the forward and back sweeps, and then we'll do fall off the logs. So music. 5, 6, 7, 8. With the claws, I think we should do the heel and toe and then add the sweep to it.
Stand on our 2 feet, feet together, but we're going to pick up our right foot and bend the left foot a little bit. And I'm going to move my weight forward. So I'm going to roll forward onto the ball of my foot so that my heel comes slightly off the floor. So I'm standing on 2 feet, but mostly on the left one, and ball on the weight on the ball of the foot. I'm going to move on the left heel and the toe and the heel and the toe and the heel and the toe and the heel and the toe. Let's try that the other way. We stand on the right foot this time, roll onto the ball of your feet, and we push the heel first and the toe and the heel and the toe and the heel and the toe and the heel and the toe.
Good, let's do that a couple of times.
Yes, a few times.
So whichever direction you're going first.
Going to the right, 5, 6, 7, and a 1, 2, 3, a 5, 6, 7, 8. reverse, 5, 6, 7, and a 1, 2, 3, a 5, 6, 7, 8.
Could you do that once to music?
Absolutely. The secret is to keep the knees bent so that you can control the movement a little bit better as well.
Anna, your feet's too big.
What?
Who's been walking around here?
5, 6, 7, and 1, 2, 3, 5, 6, 7, down, 1, 2, 3, 5, 6, 7, and...
Now, interestingly, it's not as easy as it looks, is it? So how do you keep your balance and how do you move comfortably? Because if you're totally straight, it's hard to sort of shift the weight unless you're leaning slightly.
So if I do it from the side, first of all, like I said, I'm really bending my knees and I'm pushing the hips backwards, which brings my body in a sort of C shape a little bit. And so it's easier to adjust my weight every time that I move rather than trying to be perfectly straight there. Let's try that, standing on the left. We go heel, toe, heel, toe, heel, toe, heel.
Better.
Coming back. Stand back on the right foot and heel, toe, heel, toe, heel, toe, heel.
Now, if you turn front ways, so we can see, and you stand on one foot to do the heel and toe, where's your weight? It's slightly over the left foot, the foot you're standing on.
So I'm not dead straight here. I'm actually moving my weight so that I'm standing on my left foot. If I was going to the left, I'd be standing on my right foot. So let's just do that. Standing on 2 feet, great for waiting at the bus stop. Move your weight over to the right. And move your weight over to the left. Now, I see a few of you going, oh.
Yeah, I was going to say bend the knees.
So bend the knees and thinking, rather than thinking from the shoulders and tipping over, bend a little bit more and sort of transfer across.
That's
so it's not tipping, but transferring the weight on your left foot and then shifting the weight to your right foot. So see how you stay aligned rather than tipping over. Yeah, and shift and shift. And that allows you to have more freedom and balance on one foot. And from there, you can add some embroidery. Let's do it one more time. Can we have music again? Traveling right and left. 5, 6, 7, and.
Heel and toe, and heel and toe.
And reverse. One foot
down and reverse.
5, 6, down. 5, 6, down, and.
Now, we call this class sweeps. There's a reason.
Yes, so that's the easy part.
Maybe you should do it facing people so they can see what the move looks like.
Well, actually, I was going to start with the sweep itself.
Okay.
So first, again, we're going to bend our leg. It's going to be the left one. And I'm going to draw a little circle with my right foot. So it's going to go in front of me to the right and come back. Circle and circle and circle, like you're.
And the circle is primarily in front or behind you?
It's mostly in front of me. It's mostly.
So it's not really going. That's better.
Front,
yes.
Front, side, and come back. Front, side, come back. One. But try and push the foot away from you, otherwise it's sort of. I'm not sure what to do. So really push it out. Push, push. Just for practice, let's do it on the other foot, standing on your right. And this time we send the left foot out and around. Left foot out and around. And see, again, I'm staying all over my right foot. There's no weight going on my sweeping foot. Now that we've got our heel and toe and our sweeping motion, it's going to look like this. 1, 2, 3, 5, 6, 7. 1, 2, 3, 5, 6, 7, 8. Mm-hmm. Let's have fun. Let's put them together. Just thinking about it first. Standing on the left, prepare the right foot. Start your heel and toe. We go heel and we send the foot out. Toe, heel, toe, heel, toe, heel, toe. Let's do it one more time without stopping too much. 5, 6, 7, and 1, 2, 3, 5, 6, 7, 8.
Nice.
What helps me is to have a regular rhythm. So every time I put my heel down, I send my sweep out. And every time I put my toe down, I bring it back. So it's out, in, out, in, out, in, out, in. It helps make it regular and keeping, you know, your balance and your pace. Five.
Should we get the other way?
Six. One more time this way. One, two, three, five, six, seven, eight. Now that we've mastered the way to the right, the sweep to the right, let me sweep you off your feet to the left. Standing on the right foot, get ready. We're gonna go with the heel first and send our left toe out. Five, six, seven. A one, two, three, four, five, six, seven, eight. I prefer the other side, but there's always one side that's easier. And let's do it one more time to the left. A five, six, seven, and a one, two, three. A five, six, seven, eight. Music maestro. Sweeps to the right.
Now a four one. Knee your big feet to you. From your ankle
six,
up,
six,
up
five,
and
six,
short.
Five, six, seven, and sweep.
From that down and down.
Five, six, seven,
yeah,
and to the left.
Too big.
To the right.
Don't want to cut your
feet
too big.
Two, three,
can't
four,
use
down.
It because your feet too big. I really hate you because your feet too big.
And relax. Okay, now just so you know, this move can be done if you had a partner, because we can go a one, two, three, four, five, six, seven, and. So you can, it's something you can do in your partner dancing, but also you might do it towards your partner. Three, four, five, six, seven, eight. So you could do it separately or together. And then we also need to add some arms. So very basic would be to have the arms out for balance, like a tightrope walker. You know, you've got the arms out, but maybe we want to do swimming arms. So maybe you want to swim with the arms. Let's try that.
Oh, I like this one.
Let's do that. And one, two, one, two, one, two, one, two.
Nice.
Yeah, back the other way. One, two, heel and toe. One, two, one,
nice.
Two. You may want to...
Can I just say something about the swim? So the swimming arms really mimic the shape
the
of the sweep. So really push out those arms away from you. Yes, that's it, Liz. Nice.
And then sometimes I'll do it really small. And I'll just maybe just use the hands. Especially if I'm doing it towards someone, yeah. I might just want to play with the hands a little bit, yeah. So you can play with the hands. You can have them moving in different directions. But the main thing is you do something with the hands. You might just want the hands up as though you're polishing something. You might want to swim with the
sweeping
arms.
Sweeping and polishing.
Sweeping and polishing.
You're a dream.
A dream. Sometimes I'll do a down and an up and a down and an up. So you find your way. Let's do it one last time with music.
Okay.
Five, six, seven, one.
Yeah,
your girl, she likes you, she thinks you're nice. God wants to be in paradise. She said she likes your face, she likes your ring.
One more time.
Man, oh man, things are too big.
Simon,
okay.
Your feet's too big.
Thank you. Now, let's add on another kind of sweep. So we're going
to
think...
I just have a question. Does it help to look down?
No.
Actually, it might actually unhelp.
Yeah, because you're very clever. You've got a big brain in there. And when you look down, it actually throws your balance out. You need to think a pole running through the head, through the hips, and we want to keep it all nice and straight.
Yeah,
but
so
always the arms out.
Everyone had their head a little bit down, so up.
Okay. We're going to go one, two, three, four.
Are you an ice skater or what?
Well, sort of. Funny ice skating though. And one, two, three, four. Well, we won't worry too much about the arms, but I'm going to sweep one foot in front and jump on it. Then I sweep the other foot in front and jump. So let me do it this way. So if I'm standing on the left, I sweep the right foot in front, it comes in, it crosses, and as it comes back, I jump. In, cross, jump. And one, and two, and three, and four.
Okay, running out of space now. Reset, The starting block.
Stay pretty much on the spot. And one, and two, and three, and four.
Yeah, if you move your feet back a little bit as you jump.
Yeah,
can you
from
do
the
it
side.
From the side? Yeah.
So I'm going to add, I call it my swimming arms.
Let's just do a little bit more the feet because okay.
And one, and two, and three, and four. So yes. Can you see how one foot knocks the other one out of the way almost? Yeah, this one comes in and knocks the other one out, so it sort of replaces the foot.
Yeah, nice. Again, the answer is not on the floor.
Now this one, I am definitely keeping my weight forward on the toes. And I come in and I drop, and drop, and drop, and drop. Okay. And if we went forward, we should go back. And back. And back, and back, and back.
Okay, we have, it starts really nice and then the feet become a bit squashed and you're not pushing them out. It becomes like running and we're losing the sweep. So really send your feet all the way around. That's what makes
I
it
think
so nice.
The trick is what Anna was talking about before, is I bring the leg back and underneath, and around and underneath. And one.
Yeah, big semicircle on the floor.
And as one foot lands, it shoots the other one out of the way. So if I do that one more time, I come round and round and round and. And the other thing is, imagine I've got a little pencil on the end of my big toe and I want to draw a circle or a semicircle as big as I can. Shoom. Shoom. Now, one little experiment. Stand up very tall and straight. Point your toe in front of you as far as it goes. Doesn't go any further, does it? Now, look at the mark on the floor where you are. Do not move your front leg, but as you bend the supporting leg, you'll find your front leg moves forward. If I didn't move forward, I'd have to sort of bend the knee. But if I keep the leg straight, it goes forward. So you make a bigger circle by bending your supporting leg. So if you want to make a big circle, you get down low and low. And this is what Anna was talking about, the skating feeling of having the arms help with the balance. So we can go forward and back. Let's do four forward, four back. We're going to go, stand on the left, we go one, two, three, four. I'm going to cheat to come back. I'm going to reverse. I'm going to jump back on the right foot and reverse, reverse, reverse.
We're going to have very shiny floors after this session.
And we go. One, two, three, four, and one, two, three, four.
Would you like some music?
Yes, I would. Really.
The same or the next one? Same?
Yeah, whichever.
Oh, you beat them with.
Take a bounce.
Don't want you cut your feet too big.
Six, five,
mad
six, seven.
You cut your
one,
feet too big.
Two, three, four, and one, 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 two, three, four. We're not doing it today, but I just wanted to show you that this move again, I don't know if you may or may not do Lindy Hop or dances like that, but you can use this in your Lindy Hop. So if I was a leader, I'd be going one, two, three, and four, five, six, seven, eight, one, and two, three, and four. It can fit into your partner dancing as well as solo dancing. The last variation we're going to learn today is actually a fall off the log with a sweep. So we know fall off the log because we've done it before, but we'll review it. We go, kick, one, two, three, kick, one, two, three, kick, one, and jump, two, three. So let me turn around. We'll do one basic fall off
log.
Let's
do the fall off log first, yeah.
On the left foot, pick up the right, kick out to the side, eight, one step behind, two to the side, three cross in front. Let's repeat it. Kick, behind, side, front. Let's do that whole thing. 5, 6, 7, 8.
Behind,
1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7.
Let's do it one more time because we're getting the kick on the wrong foot. So it's the outside foot that's going to kick out. Kick, and then 1, 2, 3. 1, 2, 3. And again, the outside foot kicks out. Kick, 1, 2, 3. And you want to explain very briefly how we have that falling feeling, so we go in the right direction. Fall off the log. Fall off the log. Whee off.
And there's a little bounce as well.
So make sure to take all three steps in between. So one more time, 5, 6, 7. Kick, right, left, right. Kick, left, right, left. Kick, right, left, right. Kick, left, right, left. We're getting there, that's great.
Should we do that once the music?
Yes.
You can try the next track if you want.
For variety. Well, what you gonna do?
5, 6, 7, 8, 1, 2, 3. 5, 6, 7, kick, going off the log, on the toes.
Okay, Adrian, fall off the log is your move.
Fall off the log is your move. Okay, we're going to add sweeps to the end to make it look a bit different. So it's going to go 8, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7. 8, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8. Let's do the first set of fall off the logs. We know kick behind, side, front. Kick behind, side, front. Let's stop there. Kick on 8. 1, 2, but I'm going to jump onto the next step, and at the same time as I jump onto the right foot, I'm going to sweep my left foot around. 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, good. 8 is the next kick.
That's it, everyone.
Let's do that last one, third one. 8, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8. Just want to do that fast once. 5, 6, 7, 8. 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8. Yeah. Okay. Let's add on the fall off the log. So one set of fall off the logs, one with the sweep. A 1, a 2, a you know what to do. Kick, fall off the log. Fall off the log. 8, 1, 2. Sweep, 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 kick, fall off the log. Fall off the log. 8, 1, 2, 3, 5, 7, 8.
Wait. We've got the idea, but we're missing that tricky transition in the middle.
Okay.
Of which foot to be in. I see a few nods.
Let's do it again. The last one, the third one. 8, 1, 2. But I'm going to push it a little bit. I'm going to jump onto my right foot and begin to sweep my left foot at the same time. Simultaneously, in fact. So I'm going to go 3, 4, I land. 5, 6, I land. 7, and I want to go back into fall off the log. 7, 8, 1, 2, 3.
Yeah, I think it's really the first one. The rest of the suite seems to flow quite well.
And go back into the basic?
Let's get that first transition first, because until we have that, we can't judge the end.
5, 6, number 3, 8, 1, 2, stop.
That's it. Let's do that 100 times, shoo. Simon.
5, 6, 7, 8, behind, one, side, two, spring. Jump. We call that a spring, when you jump on one foot and you lift the other one up to start the move.
So that was once, only 99 times to go.
Let's do it.
5, 6, 7, fall off the jump.
Again.
5, 6, 7, fall off the spring. Good. Let's do the same thing, but continue with the three sweeps now. 5, 6, 7, fall off the sweep. sweep, sweep, and kick. One more time, and then maybe we can slow down the last transition. 5, 6, 7. 4, off, the sweep, 2, 3, and then the last time you do it, yeah, it's the beginning of the next fall off the log. What do you do with your arms, Simon?
I'm on a tightrope, walking very high up, and I want to balance with my arms. So I keep the arms out for balance, and I try and mimic the sort of movement that I'm doing. So I would go, A, 1, 2, 3. So the arms are actually helping me to remember what to do with the feet. 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7.
So the arms are nice and out, and that will help with balance as well, rather than down against the body.
In fact, if you do a sweep, the arms go with the foot. As the leg comes in, the arms come in. As the leg comes in, the arm comes in. In fact, if you just do this, swim, 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 swim.
Is that a lockdown seaside holiday?
2, 3, 4. 1, 2, 3.
They think we've gone crazy, Simon.
2, 3, 4.
Shall we try that with the music?
We better try that with music here. Facing or away?
Away. With the, from the fall of the log. Three fall of the logs into three sweeps.
'Tis, I get lower as I go into the sweeps. So watch, I'm up here, A, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7. A, 1, 2, 3, I get down low, everything's low. 3, 5, and here, I think that's what Anna said when she said skating, like speed skaters, I'm down here to get down. Yeah, nice. That makes it a lot easier. Okay, let's do it one more time slowly. 5, 6, 7, 8, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 1, 2, spring, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 1, 2, 3, 4.
I think we're missing now the kickback, the going from the sweeps to the second following line.
Okay, number 3, 8, 1, 2, 3. I bring it around, I jump on the left foot, 4. I bring it around, I jump on the right foot, 5.
Six,
I bring it around, 6. And as I jump on the left foot, I'm picking up the right foot, ready to go, 7, 8. So it's going to be come around, 6, 7, 8.
Well, yeah.
8, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8.
So it's quite quick. The last sweep is only on 7 and you jump on 8.
So yeah, it's a quick one. So it can be a bit smaller. 7, 8, 1, 2, 3. And I'm jumping. Let's go from here. 6, sweep the left foot round.
7, 8.
Let's do that again. 6, 7, 8.
Straight into the fall of the log. And well, not to fall, really, on the fall of the log.
It's a fake fall, we pretend to fall.
Yeah. Let's show how it's a fake and how you keep your balance on the fall.
5, 6, 7, 8.
Okay, so you're moving your
control.
Weight over, and can you do it to the side?
Mm-hmm.
Sideways.
5, 6, 7, 8.
So look how Simon, don't move, don't you dare. His hips are back. So again, that C shape we're talking about, so it's easier. Bend those knees and really, really push those hips back.
Okay, we need to try all three moves with music.
Okay.
So
we have a quick recap.
Okay, we could put it together in a routine, but let's do a vague routine. Let's start with number 1, heel and toe. We'll do it a few times. Then we'll do the sweeps. and then we'll do the, you know, the forward and back sweeps, and then we'll do fall off the logs. So music, do you want to do the slow song or the slightly quicker one?
I mean that one.
Yeah, good. Heel and toe. Five, six, seven, eight. So that sort of movement will help you when you want to do like heel and toe turns. So it's all good practice.
And stylish. It's a nice little styling to add on a lot of moves.
So just to recap, we did a heel and toe and added some stylish arms. We did a sweep, either frontwards or backwards. And then we did a fall off the log variation with a sweep, going back into our fall off the log. Thank you, guys.
Fantastic. Thank you very much. Have a great week.